Señor, aquí tiene.
Gracias.
I'm not a hero. There were some in the hunt for Escobar. A lot, actually. But it's tough to see them through all the blood. To kill a monster, sometimes you have to get in bed with other monsters. If that surprises you, pick up a history book. It's what we do. The enemy of my enemy is my friend, until he becomes my enemy again. When that happens, God help them. The day Pablo went down, the Cali cartel became public enemy number one. And the fact that they helped us bring him down didn't mean shit.
Many observers fear Colombia's other large cartel, the Cali cartel, will now simply step up its own drug production.
And that's exactly what happened. While the whole world was focused on Escobar, Cali's operations had grown exponentially, differing from their rival in every possible way. Where Pablo sought the love and protection of the masses of Medellin, these guys rubbed shoulders with Colombia's elite and called themselves the Gentlemen of Cali. And whereas Escobar craved the spotlight, these guys stayed in the shadows, perfecting the game, building complex smuggling and distribution networks through Mexico, Europe, and the Far East, without leaving so much as a fingerprint. Even the people working for them didn't know it was Cali coke they were moving. It was fucking Cocaine Incorporated, and they ran it like a Fortune 500 company. So without further ado, meet the management team of the Cali cartel. Pacho Herrera, head of distribution and security.
Hello.
He led a team of young psychopaths who would do anything he asked. Chepe Santa Cruz Londoño.
A ver. Dos horas más pa' acá. Dos horas más.
Grew up with the Rodriguez brothers. He was in charge of U.S. operations and responsible for Cali's crown jewel, New York City. He actually lived there, under an assumed name, of course. Cartel's number two was operations chief Miguel Rodriguez.
El superintendente de la policía de Palmira.
¿Pero eso no lo hicimos ya?
El que yo le digo a usted es el nuevo, es Arango.
¿Cuánto?
Le pongo 20,000.
No. Ponele 17.
17.
Sí.
Miguel watched over all the money coming in and what bribes they were paying out. And last but not least, cartel CEO, the man with the plan, Gilberto Rodriguez. They called him the chess player because he was always one move ahead. They were the pinnacle of trafficking evolution, apex drug dealers. And being number two allowed them to quietly grow into the biggest cocaine cartel in history. Except now that was over. Now that the guy that occupied our attention was gone, they were number one with a fucking bullet. And there was no chess move that would get them out of it. But I was looking forward to seeing them try.
Anderson,